So that was Surah 37 verse 12. Open your file.
Surah 37 verse
37.
37.
Yeah. I'm sure you know that since you said you've done the homework. Yeah.
Okay, it's this one, isn't it? It's this one.
Surah 37?
Right.
Is that Surah 37?
Yeah, yeah. You're amazed as they ridicule.
Okay.
Right? You know, you're amazed. Now, this is the commentary, right?
That's not the commentary, that's the footnote.
Okay, that's the footnote.
Yeah, right. There are two different things, by the way.
This is the one where it says rather, that's where it signifies about the amazed bit. So, rather I gravely noticed as they ridicule.
So, it is, you were amazed, now I amazed.
It doesn't say amazed, does it? You said that, you know.
In one of them it is you, in other one it is I. Is there a difference?
But they work together.
Brother, are you still English?
Just I am still English.
You are still English. Can you tell me what is the difference?
What does it say amazed?
Focus. Okay. Bring your ears. Yeah. I see ya, ears see ya. Okay. What is the difference between I and you?
I, you. So,
no, I didn't get it. Listen, are you listening?
Yes.
What is the difference between I and you?
It's the difference between I am hungry and you are hungry.
So okay. What is the difference?
Just ask him a question.
No. I'm trying to understand. He's not here to be barbecued.
I know.
You made stupid claim. Okay. So, is it Allah who is amazed? Or it is Muhammad or Muslims who are amazed.
Right, well in the Quran, if it says I am amazed, in the Quran it means
No. He said he did his homework, so yeah. let's hear. Is it Allah or Muhammad? Who is amazed?
If the Quran says I am amazed.
If Quran says I am amazed, it means Allah is amazed.
So okay.
If Quran says you are amazed, it means Muhammad.
Is there a difference between Allah and Muhammad?
Asked me this question before.
Answer. Is there a difference between Allah and Muhammad?
Why can't you look at this? Rather, I gravely noticed. It's not rather I was amazed. It's rather I gravely noticed.
So who is that I? Who is that I?
Of course, that's wait. The I is Allah.
I is Allah. Go to the Quranic verse. Go on the top.
Right.
Who is that? Who is that you?
The you is Muhammad.
Okay.
Yes.
So in the Quran. In that Quran it is you, and then you come to the footnote, it says there is a Quran which is I. Let me ask you basic question. Is there a difference between Allah and Muhammad?
Is there a difference between
Allah cannot read and write. Muhammad cannot read and write. Allah has two right hands. How many right hands does Muhammad have?
You're lying in front of my face. Because literally the word noticing and the word amazed is different.
Sir,
yes.
Who is the one who is amazed or who is the one who is noticed? Who is that person?
It works together and I'll tell you why. It gives a deeper meaning. That's the purpose of the
paper. Are they same or different?
Different meaning.
Seriously go and do, I don't know where they teach alphabet. Which level?
Primary school.
Primary school. Please go to the primary school and then ask the teacher. Is there a difference between I and you? Is there a difference between Allah and Muhammad? I know that they've got some common thing, okay? Allah cannot read and write. Muhammad cannot read and write. Allah cannot balance. Muhammad cannot balance. Allah full of lust. Muhammad full of lust. So, they are the common things. Is there a difference, according to you, between Allah and Muhammad?
Okay. First of all, the verse clearly says, like I said in the beginning, rather I gravely notice as they ridicule. And then in the Quranic verse, it says, you were amazed. You were amazed as they ridicule.
Okay, yes. The part I am focusing is I and you, because that is changing from Allah to Muhammad.
Let me tell you one.
Who is the one who is amazed?
Right. First of all, Allah wasn't amazed. But let's try.
Allah wasn't.
He wasn't amazed. He knew.
Okay, so when the Quran says I, Allah is lying or that Quran is false?
No, it works together. Let me tell you why.
No. Just answer a very basic question. When it says I, is Allah lying?
No.
No. Okay. When it says I, is that Quran rubbish? Is that Quran should to be put in the bin? Is that wrong Quran?
It's not, because it's different Qur'an.
Is that right Quran or wrong Quran?
In my sense, that's right Quran. Yeah,
that's right Quran. So,
yes,
when it says, listen, when it says I, Allah is the one who is amazed, okay? So you are saying that is not Allah who is amazed, but that is right Quran. I didn't understand that. Look, explain it to me.
Okay, I'll explain it to you plainly. Right? So, rather I gravely notice as they ridicule. The word gravely noticing, right, means that Allah knew. He saw it happening. Right? Whilst Muhammad was amazed because he didn't know it was happening, but now he found out. Allah is the all-knowing, therefore he only noticed. Whilst Muhammad was amazed, because of course he didn't know, he's only human, he's not divine.
I really encourage you to go to the primary school and then learn what is the difference between I and you. My basic question is very simple.
Not this one. Look, what's the difference between noticing and being amazed? There's a difference.
Sir, that's not my focus. My focus question is...
So there were two differences between the different Qur'an then. Well, see, I only
in that sentence, but that's not what I am focusing. The part I am focusing is, it is, who is the subject? Who is the subject in that sentence? Allah or Muhammad?
The purpose of these different Qur'an...
Who is the subject in the correct Qur'an?
Let me go. Can I answer this?
I don't want you to, I want you to make it very simple. Is the subject in the correct Quran?
Right. So, yesterday, I did a little bit of research on the qira'at, right? I'm on the topic, don't worry. Different Qurans, if they might have different, you know, different meanings, those two different meanings, they work together, as in, they give a deeper meaning, basically.
So, Allah and Muhammad works together, and then they go to the park. Allah and Muhammad works together, they feed the ducks. Is that what you are saying, sir? Subject is different. I know there is something in the brain doesn't get it, okay? Maybe it is just you've been here 3 weeks and that in homework you've done in 3 weeks frozen your brain so far. Allah and Muhammad are two different beings. Unless they are mixed-matched as the Christmas turkey or something. You, I, two different things. Who is the subject in the Quran? There are two different Qurans, okay? Which Quran is the one which is the correct Quran? You were the one last week who told us there is only one Quran. So in that only one Quran, is it Allah the subject or is Muhammad the subject in Surah 37 verse 12?
I'll give you the answer, both.
How can it be both? Brother, you are English.
Yes.
How can it be both? Is it saying Allah and Muhammad going and feeding the donkeys? Allah and Muhammad both flying on the top of the horse? Allah and Muhammad both of them changing their socks?
Look, let me tell you.
Is Allah and Muhammad are both amazed?
Literally. They're not one. Okay, first of all, they're not both
amazed. Allah and the other, Muhammad is amazed.
So which one is correct?
We're trying to put the word amazed into that second in the footnote. You're putting the word amazed into the footnote.
I'm not putting that. I've got two different Qurans. Let me show it to you.
Show me in the footnote. It wasn't correct. Rather, I was...
So, if you want to make case, Surah 37 verse 12 has lots of textual variations within it. Go and do that case. I'm making a theological point, okay? According to Islam, if you think they are together, then you are saying Allah and Muhammad hangs out together, they go and drink coffee. If that's what you want them to do it, that's absolutely fine. Go and butcher. So, focus, put your brain together and ears together. So, according to that verse, you have to pick only one of them. Are you going to pick Muhammad or Allah? Are you going to pick you or I? That's very, very simple. So now, let me open. I don't want you to give me example. I already got the example. You just need to fix it. And then tell me which Quran needs to go in the bottom of the, I don't know, toilet or somewhere. I don't know where what
you're
people do with their Quran.
That's the 37 verse 12, right?
Yeah, okay. I'm going to show it to you.
Okay. I just want to know. Because in the British translation, it doesn't say whether I was in it. All right, show me one. Which one? Verse 12. Truly dost thou marvel Yeah, the thou means you, right?
Yes. I can't wait for you.
I've got Arabic next to it, sir.
Arabic there. Okay.
Okay.
Arabic.
Yes, some of them.
The question is not can you read Arabic, the question is can you understand that magical language which Allah fails to communicate, oh, very basic. So, he is the same word, okay? Brother, can you bring them next to each other?
Ben Ajib too, and that one says Bel Ajib, Bel Ajibta.
Okay, so
one is Ajibto, one is Ajibta,
okay.
Is
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's correct. So, how can, according to you, suddenly full meaning of the sentence is changing, okay? That's first thing you've got to think through. But my core question is, who is the one amazed? Is it Allah or is it Muhammad? That's very simple one-to-one question. It's not about I understand Arabic or not. That's,
we can just see this.
It is very clear. If you get on the line, I'll talk to you.
I saw you on YouTube.
Get on the line.
It has nothing to do with you saw me on YouTube or not. I'm asking the very basic question. Is it Allah? Is it Allah or is it Muhammad, sir?
First of all, you need to do to find differences is read the blue.
No.
Right.
No.
Yeah, yeah.
So there are differences. No, okay. I don't want to talk about there are in the, from this one to this one, there are 5,000 differences. I'm not going to talk about it.
Okay.
Yeah, they're giving the different meaning. They give different meaning.
Of course, so, this is English and this is Arabic. Of course, going to be difference.
Really?
Yeah, of course. This is
you must be the next Arstein.
This is the translation. This is the original. Of course.
This is the Arabic.
This is
that is the Arabic. Okay, that is the Arabic.
Brother, he just left. He just left bosom of his mother's.
Right, okay.
Sir, can you please?
Yeah, who made
can you please tell me?
So
is it Allah or Muhammad?
Who made it? Who
so this
it?
Is.
This is the one that says.
Yusuf Ali translation. That's Yusuf Ali translation.
Yusuf Ali. Okay.
So if Yusuf Ali says that, so this is the half of the way. Which one is this?
Oh, how many are there?
I mean, but it doesn't mean that they're different.
How many are there?
Anyways, which phrase?
How many are there?
Translation
are different. If there's 10 qira'at, I think, and then 3 of them, there's probably 7 qira'at. Or 7 qira'at.
You don't even know the numbers?
Seven
how ahruf, many Qurans
seven
are there?
7 ahruf and 10 qira'at, yes.
7 ahruf and 10 qira'at?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
That's what I've learned.
Yeah, you've got to do homework. Go to the primary school. So now answer the basic question. Is it Allah or is it Muhammad?
So if that one says Bel Ajibto,
you still wearing that t-shirt?
So Bel Ajibto and Bel Ajibto. First of all, I need to see what the difference would be if it's two or two.
You said you did homework. Okay? So according to your homework, which you said you did, what is the difference between them?
The homework I did was the book that you showed me. The 10 qira'at by Bridges.
Sir, I did show you this last week as well. What is the difference between I and you? Ma'am, how old are you? 12. Is there a difference between I and you? Yes, even the 12 years old knows there is differences. Allah doesn't know there are differences or not. You are over 12. He knows there are differences. I am over 12. There are differences. Arabic has already been read. I want you to tell me the differences. I want you to tell me the differences.
This one, Bel Ajibto.
Bel Ajibto. Okay.
Bel Ajibto and Bel Ajibto.
Okay, so what's your point?
So Ajibto and Ajibta are different.
Yeah, okay, what's the point?
What is the difference?
He was amazed. Was it Allah?
What is the difference?
Well, Ajibto. Ajibto wa yaskharun. Ajibto, that's what talking about me. I did Ajibto.
You did Ajibto.
Ajibta is a brother.
Okay, that's you. In this one?
Ajibta. In this one, yeah?
Bel Ajibta. Wait, but I didn't finish it.
Okay.
Bel Ajibta, yes.
Bel Ajibta wa yaskharun. Okay, what's the point? Fatha Dhamma.
Ma'am, focus. So you were amazed. It was you. In here, who is the one?
So what's the difference? It's the same thing.
How can it be the same while in this one it is you?
What it says here, Bel Ajibta wa yaskharun. And here, Bel Ajibta wa yaskharun. What's the difference?
You know yeah, you tell me.
No. It's in a grammar here. It's called Fatha and Dhamma. You tell me now, what's the difference between Fatha and Dhamma?
Is there a difference? Is there a difference between I and you?
Now you say
I am answering the question, ma'am. Pull yourself together. I am answering the question. Is there a difference between Allah and Muhammad?
Ask me if you don't know the language.
Yes, there is a difference between Allah and Muhammad. All I'm asking is it Allah or Muhammad?
Between Dhamma and Fatha, what's the difference? If you know the grammar. She's making a claim.
I am not making a claim. Claim is here. There is a difference between I and you.
Okay,
شو الفرق بين الفتحة والضمة؟ هنا في
الحالة دي اللي بنقول last week. Same discussion.
إذا عجزت أنا أتكلم.
Still waiting for other فتحة هاتون.
إذا عجزت.
Sir, don't harass me, please. Thank you. You are harassing me. I feel I am harassed. I am being harassed, officer. Yeah, he's over there.
شنو بنفس الصورة؟
That's what you've done. That's what you've been doing. Sir.
مكتوب هنا بل عجبت ويسخرون. بل عجبت ويسخرون. الحين في الجملتين وين في فرق؟ متحدث باللغة العربية.
Can you check the time?
كيف الفرق في المعنى؟
هي الضمة لها.
لا أنا سألتك المعنى.
معنى جايك.
حلو.
الضمة لها معنى مدلول والفتحة لها مدلول.
أوكي.
إذا عجزت أنا أتحدث مع هذا الرجل إذا عجزت.
مو عجزت عجبت. هل عجبت ويسخرون؟
I'm recording, yes sir.
خلاص يعني أنا بالضم إذا عجبت وإذا عجبت تكلم عن نفسك.
So
أنا الحين عندك.
Is there a difference?
Wait.
So now he confirms that there is you and I. All I am asking is which one is the correct?
Let him concentrate.
He already made a point. He already made a point. Allah doesn't know. I am not Allah. I know better than Allah. I know better than Allah. Is it Allah or is it Muhammad?
Yes.
You know why you're going to die?
I know better than Allah.
Is it
Allah or Muhammad, sir? Which Quran is the correct?
في فرق بين الجملتين في المعنى.
The difference between those two verses is the two on the top.
Sorry?
لا خلينا بنعم ولا أول شيء.
And the top.
لا خلينا بنعم.
Difference between yeah that makes I to you. Okay, so that makes I Allah is the speaking, you Muhammad. Okay, so I am asking which one is the correct.
First of all, going into this one is that you know there are. For example, I'll even give you another difference right now.
No. I can give you 93,000 differences. I am asking especially for this difference. But now we acknowledge that that is different and it does change the meaning. I am asking which one is the correct Quran. That's very simple.
If Allah was amazed.
So is it this Quran or is it this Quran?
Which Quran is this one? Al-Kha is this
Khalat. Khalat.
Right. So of course this was also mentioned in the British Foundation. Right, book. It's also mentioned.
It's all right, it's me. Just making sure it's safe. Sorry, I have to not just making sure it's safe.
So, in the British translation...
No. What is my question?
Okay, your question is whether it's high or it's...
No. We already established that. My question, listen carefully, my question is which Quran is the correct one? Okay, that's my question.
They both work well with each other because...
No, they might work well with each other, okay? Wife and husband get on well. Boss and colleague get on well. Two children get on very well. They work better together. That's not my question. I'm not asking, are those Qurans are good at playing together and get on well? I am asking which one is the correct one? Because last week you made a claim that there is only one Quran, but they are different. The question is, which one is the correct one?
Let me elaborate on what I said.
No. I don't want you to elaborate on all that junk. Which one is the correct one? Simple question. Which one is the correct one?
Both of them are right.
So how can both of them be right if there is only one Quran? How can both of them be right if there are two different Qurans?
What's the difference between Dhamma? Wait, brother. Tell me what's the difference between Dhamma and Fatha?
Which Quran is correct, man? Which Quran is correct?
With Dhamma and
Fatha. Which Quran is the correct?
Tell me.
Which one is the correct? Both of them can't be correct if there is only one Quran. There are two different Qurans. I'm holding in my hand. Which one is the Quran?
Since 1,400 years, many people, like you said.
Sir, which one is correct?
And you know, she don't have the language. She don't have the language.
You know what? The purpose of different qira'at, like this one, Wattu and Ti, which is different qira'at, of course, she only gives a deeper meaning. For example,
I'm not asking the deeper meaning.
You know, for example,
my question is very, very, very simple. I'm not asking you to give me your Friday khutbah. You told us there is only one Quran. You saw they are different from Allah to Muhammad. Which one is the correct one Quran? Because only one of them is going to intercede for you on the day of judgment. Only one of them, okay? Not two of them coming together and working together to intercede for you. One of them is going to appear as a pale man and going to intercede for you. Which one?
And watch.
This woman, she's not even a Christian.
Her way is like that.
Anti-Islamic.
I'm still waiting for the answer, Muslim.
So you shouldn't even give her any platform or anything.
No, but
if she have any doubt, there is so many websites she follows. No,
can I just express my freedom of speech is being taken away by the Dawah gangs, as Dawah gangs are coming and taking people away from my conversations? That's under the harassment.
And she has to get paid. She's on the payroll. So what
please bring my pay slips. Jews are over there. Ask them why they haven't been paying me. Which Quran is correct? Coming and telling. The Wagangs are coming and telling and lies about me. But which one is the correct one? You can lie. You can take people away. On the day of judgment, when you stand in front of Holy God, you are not going to be able to hold all those lies. Which Quran is the correct one? Quran number one, Quran number two, Allah or Muhammad? Which one? It does matter, because two of them are not going to come alongside each other and then unite and then come, play together, work well together. Only one of them is going to intercede for you. It's been a couple of minutes. Muslim Dawah, Islamic Dawah gangs are still begging other Muslims to not talk to me. Let's see.
Yes. What are those two books?
It's true.
They are the holy, so-called holy book of Muslims.
Holy what?
Holy book of Muslims.
Both of them?
Yeah.
Are they the same or different?
They are different.
So we have two Qurans that are different.
There are 30. Right now I am holding two, but there are 37.
How many in total?
37.
37. And what's the difference between the two?
Oh, well, one of them says Allah, other one says Muhammad. Is Allah MS or Muhammad MS? I'm trying to figure that out. But as you can see, Islamic Dawah gangs wants to take my freedom of speech away and not allow me to have conversations. It is harassment. Mr. Policeman is over there. And they just turn blind eye to harassment. And this is harassment as well. I feel right now I am being harassed.
Okay, so this one says Allah and this one says Muhammad.
One of them says Allah is MS.
Amazed? What's amazed mean?
Wow.
Oh, okay, and the other one says Muhammad is.
Yeah, you amazed. So I'm asking which one is the correct one.
Because in the same verse.
Yeah, because Muslims believe there is only one Quran. Not even a dot change. So I'm asking if there is only one Quran, why there are different. Yeah. Sir, which Quran is correct? Don't cry. If you are gonna cry, go and stay behind your mother's skirt. Don't tell me what to say. Don't tell me what to say.
Jesus doesn't love you. Jesus doesn't love you.
Thank
you very much.
Oh well, it's been wild. Dawah gang still not allowing them to speak to me. But here's the bottom line. There are different Arabic Qurans, and still, without any shame, Muslims are making a claim there is only one. Apparently, he said he did his homework. After his homework, he became more confused and more messed up. Your mess only can be cleaned by the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. Turn to him while you can.